Welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Ayush Jain and today I am giving you the demo of Breadboard Circuit Lab. The order code of this equipment is 33508. Now, this is our equipment. Before coming to the experiments, first let me explain you all the blocks on this equipment. I will show you how these blocks work. So, first of all, we have DC power supply over here. DC power supply, which shows 0 to 12 volt variable supply at 500 milliampere. I'll show you. Connect this positive and ground. Connect this positive to positive and ground to negative. Now this is the main power switch on off button. This button, as we switch on, RKit will be on. Now we have kept this knob to variable to see the variation of the voltage. Now as I increase the voltage, you can see the variation of the voltage. It varies from 0 to approximately 12 volt. As you can see, here is 11.8. Now if we kept it at fixed, it will give you a fixed voltage of approximately 12 volt. Then this knob will not work. This is the function of this block. Now the function of this block, DC power supply minus 12 volt at 500 milliampere. So connect positive to positive and negative to ground. So keep this switch to variable. Now as I increase the voltage, it will show me negative voltage. As you can see over there, here in the LCD, it will show me negative minus 12 voltage approximately, as you can see. And if we keep this knob to fixed position, then it will give you a fixed minus 12 volt. Then this knob will not work. Our next block is the DC power supply 5 volt, fixed 5 volt at 500 milliampere. That you can see. It is approximately 5 volt, which is 4.97. You can see in the LCD. This block, block number 3, is an AC power supply. It is 9 volt to 9 volt. So if I connect it from 0 volt to 9 volt, as it is an AC reading, this LCD will not show the AC reading. For this, we will use a DMM, set it on the AC mode, connect this positive to positive and negative to black. And you can see at the AC mode, it is showing 9 volt. Now if instead of at 0, I connect it to second 9, which is 9 to 9, it will show me 18 volt approximately, as you can see in the DMM, at the AC mode, as it is AC power supply. Now these are the various LEDs that can be used as the output of different experiments. If I connect my plus 5 volt to this wire and give voltage to these LEDs will glow, as you can see. Now, the function of this continuity tester. In this continuity tester, if you connect this, if a wire is connected between these two terminals, the buzzer will blow and the buzzer will blow and the light will glow. As you can see, this shows the continuity. Now, the working of this LEDs. These are the logic level inputs. Logic 1 this side and logic 0 this side. So this shows, through this you can give the input to different experiments. by giving logic 1 or logic 0. Now, the working of these blocks, these are the resistance blocks, potentiometer blocks. Now, the working of these blocks now this block, which is 1k potentiometer, now it has three ports. If we attach a wire to the extreme left and the right port, this will give you the exact 1k resistance without any variation. To see the variation in the potentiometer, take the two ports which are combined, which are together, first and the second one, and connect it to the DMM to measure the resistance. As it is a 1k pot, I have set the DMM to 2000 ohm. Now, as I vary this knob, you can see the variation in the resistance. It ranges from 0 to approximately 1k. This is the working of 1k potentiometer. If I put this to the extreme point, then this variation will not work. You will get exact approximately 1000 ohm resistance. Now, this is a 10k potentiometer. For this, we have to select 20k in DMM. If we take the two extreme points, then we will get the fixed resistance of approximately 10 kilo ohm. And to see the variation, how the potentiometer varies, I connect it to the middle port, and as I increase the resistance through this knob, my resistance in the DMM is increasing, as you can see. This is the working of 10k potentiometer block. Now, this is our 100k potentiometer block. For this, I keep my knob to 200k. Now, to see the variation, I have connected between the first and the second port. Now, as I increase my resistance through this knob, my resistance in the DMM is increasing, as you can see. If I connect it to the extreme point, then I'll get approximately 100 kilo ohm fixed resistance. These are the working of this potentiometer blocks. Now, this is our speaker. In order to see the working of speaker, connect plus 5 volt in ground. Connect plus 5 volt to this point and ground to this point. And as we switch on, you can hear the voice from the speaker. This is the working of speaker. Now, we have these two blocks which works as clock generator. For this, we need a CRO to see the waveform. For this, we need a CRO to see the waveform generated by these blocks. Now, first of all, I show you the pulse, manual pulse generator. For this, use this CRO cable to connect it to this block with the help of patch cords. Now, after connecting it, set it to the DC mode through this. Set it to the DC mode. Now, as you switch on the main board, then as you give manually the pulse, you will see the variation in the amplitude of the DC mode. You can see initially it is here. as it is not showing exactly the variation because just a fraction of seconds that the pulse come, but you can see the slight variation as I give the manual pulser. Now the clock generator block. For the clock generator block, set it in the AC mode from here. Now this is my 0.1 hertz frequency. As it is very less frequency, it is difficult to see the waveform correctly. The frequency is very less, so the waveform is not proper. Now this is my 1 hertz. You can see over here, this is my 1 hertz. This is also very less, so my frequency in the CRO is not proper. Now this, as the frequency increases, this to 100 Hz, my waveform in CRO is like this. You can see. Now this is my 1K Hz, as the frequency is large enough to get the proper waveform, as you can see. Now this was the working of all these blocks. Now to move on the experiments, there are various experiments that can be performed on the breadboard circuit lab, as there are various ICs for NOT gate, OR, AND, NOR, NAND, XOR and XNOR. As you can see in our experiment list, there are different working of the different ICs. From NOT, OR, AND, NOR, NAND, XOR, XOR, and there are various theorems that are based on these ICs. So in order to show the working, I select one of the theorems and show you the experiment of that theorem, and the rest you can see by yourself, as the connections are similar and approximately how I do with one theorem. As I am showing you, the other theorems can be done. All the connections for other theorems is given correctly and directly in our manual, so please consult the manual to see the connections of the other theorems. I am showing you the connection of one theorem, which is 2.2.15, which will show you AB plus A bar C plus BC equal to AB plus A bar C. Now I am showing you the working of theorem number 15, which is AB plus A bar C plus BC will give you AB plus A bar C. This is the circuit diagram, how we have to make the connections, and this is the output table. So I'll make the connections and then show you the output according to the table mentioned in our lab manual. Now first let me make the connections. For this, you need IC 7404, which is a NOT gate IC. Connect it in this manner on the breadboard. You need another IC 7408, which is an AND gate IC. Connect it behind it. In these two blocks, all the five panels, vertical five panels, are short, and the horizontal are open, but the vertical five are short. And in these panels, as you can see over here and here, these small panels, the horizontal 5 blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 horizontal 5 blocks are short, and these horizontal 5 blocks are short, but vertically they are open. The another IC you need is 7432. This is an OR gate IC. Connected ahead of this. Now how to make connections? I have to give 3 inputs A, B and C. So take first input from one and give it to point, give it to the first pin of 7408 AND gate. Connect B to 3, third logic level, and give it to the second pin of 7408. C to 5, third input, and connect it to the fifth point of 7408. Now connect pin number 1 of 7408 to pin number 1 of 7404 NOT gate and take the output of NOT gate from pin number 2 of NOT gate and put it to pin number 4 of 7408. Now take the output of 7408 from the pin number 3 and put it to pin number 1 of 7432 OR gate, and from pin number 6 to pin number 2 of OR gate. Now connect A, which we have given to pin number 1, to pin number 10 of 7408. Sorry, you have to give B, not A, you have to give B, which is at pin 2 to pin 10. And you have to give C, which is at pin 5. You have to give C at pin number 9. And the output from pin number 8, you have to give to the pin number 5 of OR gate. And pin number 3 output to input pin number 4 of OR gate. And the output, final output, will be taken from pin number 6 of OR gate, and you can give it to any LED port. Now you have to give VCC plus 5 volt to the pin number 14 of all the 3 ICs. As the vertical legs are short, so I take it from this only and give it to the 14 pin of this IC. This and give it to this IC, and ground taken from this port, ground to pin number 7 of all the 3 ICs. Now these are the connections that we have made. As the connections are very tedious, so please consult the lab manual before making it. Now as I switch on my supply, now this is my logic table that we have given in our manual. Now these are the three inputs A, B, C. These are the intermediate outputs, and this is the final output which we will see at the LED 7 which we have given. Now if my input is 000, my output is 0. As you can see, when my all three inputs are 0, my output is 0. Now if I give my third input 1 and my first two input 0, then my output will be 1. My first input is 0, my second input is 0, and if my third input is 1, my output is 1. As you can see, I have given in a table. And if my all the inputs are 1, my output will be 1. My output is 1. Like this, you can take all the different readings at different input states and you can take the output. Similarly, that's it in this experiment. Similarly, you can perform various other theorems given in our manual and see the working of different ICs. OR gate, NAND gate, NOT gate. I have shown you the working of these three ICs. Similarly, you can check the working of the other ICs. All the circuits are very simple and given correctly in our lab manual. Now the second experiment. For that, let me get ready for the second experiment. Now, in the second experiment, we can measure the low state input current, high state input current, low state output voltage, and high state output voltage. There are four circuits to measure these. I am showing you one of these circuits, how to measure it, and the rest are similar. Just you have to vary the position of the DMM to measure the different current and voltages. So I'm showing you high state output voltage. Rest you can do in the same way as given in our manual. I'm showing you one, you can do rest accordingly. So for this, you need a 7400 NAND gate IC. This is the set of ICs that we provide you. You need a 7400 NAND gate IC connected in this manner. Now provide 5 volt VCC to the 14th pin of the IC, ground to the 7th pin. Now give ground 0 input to 1 and 2, both the inputs. So I short 1 and 2 and then connect it to the ground. As you know, the vertical ports are short, so we can connect it like this. Now we will take a DMM and measure the high state output voltage. For this, take the output from pin number 3 and ground from common from pin number 7. You can take the ground. Now connect the pin number 3 to the red point. And ground to the black. Now as we switch on, set it to the voltage. Now as you switch on, you will get the high state output voltage, which is approximately 5 volt. Which is approximately 5 volt, 4.47. This is the high state output voltage. Similarly, you can calculate the low state output voltage and low state input current and high state input current. Now I move further. Now, as I move further, we come across different flip-flops. We have RS flip-flop, RS flip-flop using NOR gates, first RS flip-flop using NAND gates. We have clogged RS flip-flops using NAND gates. We have JK flip-flop using NAND gate. We have clogged JK flip-flop and master-slave JK flip-flop. Further, we have D flip-flop and T flip-flop. These are different flip-flops, and for these flip-flops we have provided you different ICs. I show you the working of first RS flip-flop. I'll show you the working of clogged RS flip-flop. And before this, I show you the working of RS flip-flop using NOR gates. This is the circuit diagram that I am going to perform. RS flip-flop using NOR gates. So for this, we need a 7404 NOR gate IC. This is my 7404 NOT gate IC connected like this, and I need a 7402 NOR gate IC. This is my 7402 NOR gate IC. As the pins are very delicate, you have to connect it carefully. This is my 7402 NOR gate IC. Now the connections. Now connect S as one input to pin 1 of NOT gate, and output from pin number 2, connect it to pin 2 of NOR gate. Now connect our second input to pin 3 of NOT gate. And output from pin 4 of NOT gate, connect it to pin 6 of NOR gate, from NOT to NOR. Now connect pin number 1 of NOR gate to pin 5 of NOR gate, and connect pin number 4 to pin number 3 of NOR gate. Now for the output, connect pin number 1 to an LED which is Q and connect pin number 4. To another LED which works as Q bar or Q dash. Now connect VCC plus 5 volt to pin number 7. This is obvious and don't forget it to connect it every time. We have to connect VCC plus 5 volt to pin number 14 of both the ICs and ground to pin number 7. I connect ground to pin number 7 of both the IC. These are the connections. Now as I switch on, now this is my table. When I give 00, there is no change. If I give 01, this is my first input, this is my second input, this is 0, and as I give 01, this is Q and Q bar. So in the RS flip-flop, this is my S input and this is my R input. So if I give S 1, this will set and my Q will be 1 and my Q bar will be 0. Similarly, if I give R as 1, this will give my Q as 0 and Q bar will be 1. If my both inputs are 1, then it will give me the same output as previous output. This is the working of RS flip-flop. Now we move on to the next flip-flop, which is JK flip-flop. Now I'll show you the working of JK flip-flop. First let me get ready for the connections. Now my second flip-flop is JK flip-flop. For this we need a 7400 NAND gate IC. So this is my 7400 IC connected to the breadboard. Now the connections are, first of all make sure you connect plus 5 volt VCC to 14th pin. And ground to 7th pin. Now connect input 1J to pin 1, input K to pin 5. Now connect pin 2 to pin number 10 and pin number 10 is then connected to pin number 11. Pin number 3 is connected to pin number 9. Similarly, pin number 4 is connected to pin number 12. And then pin number 12 is connected to pin number 8. Now pin number 6 is connected to pin number 13. Now pin number 8 is connected with the output LED as Q, and pin number 11 is connected as the output as Q bar. Now if I give 10 in JK, then my output is 10. And if I give 00, my same state will come as the previous state. If I give 01, then my output is 01 as Q and Q bar. If I give 0, and now if I give 11, at 11 my output will toggle. Now you can see in the table, at 00 it will be the same, at 10 it will give 10 as set, at 01 reset, and at 11 it is the toggle state. This was the working of the JK flip flop. There are various other flip-flops that you can work on. It's clearly given in the manual as master slave JK flip-flop and etc. D flip-flop and T flip-flop. Now we move on to adder, subtractor. Multiplexer, checkers, even odd parity checkers. Now I will show you the working of full adder, and the rest you can see from our manual, which is clearly given all the circuits and the connections. So for the full adder, this is the circuit diagram. As you can see, this is the circuit diagram for the full adder. Now first let me make the connections. For this you need a 7486 IC, 7408 IC, and 7432 IC. So this is my 7486 IC.
You also need a 7408 IC.
This is my 7408 IC. And we also need a 7432 IC. This is my 7432 IC. Now, how this works? First of all, connect VCC plus 5 volt to the 14th pin of all the ICs. They're connected, and ground to the 7th pin. Now we have to give input A. You take it from 1, give it to pin 1 of 7486. And we have to give the same input to pin 2 of 7408. Connect pin 2 of 7486 and 7408, one pin, and two pin of 7486, connect them. Now take the output of 7486 from pin number 3 and connect it to pin number 4 of 7486. And also connect it to pin number 5 of 7408. Now connect pin number 5 of 7486 and pin number 4 of 7408. Now take the output of 7408 from pin number 3 and give it to pin number 1 of 7432. And the next out, pin number 6 of 7408. Connect it to pin number 2 of 7432. And connect the output to any LED from pin number 3. This is as carry, which I have given at pin, which is LED 7. Connect the output of 7486 pin number 6 and give it to an LED, this 8, which works as sum. Now we also have to give a C in input. C in input to pin number 5 and pin number 4. Pin number 5 of 7486 and pin number 4 of 7408, which is short. So I take a C in from 8 pin and give it to any pin of 7486 to 7408. Now, as I switch on my circuit, when my A and C in is 1-1, which is, then my sum will be 1, as you can see, and my carry will also be 1. You can see over here. When my A, B and C in, all 3 are 1-1, then my sum will be 1 and my carry will be 1. In this, B is given same as A. In our circuit, we have given B same as A. So means A is 1, so B is also 1, and if C is 1, then our sum and carry both are 1-1. If we give B, A and B as 1-1 and C in 0, so then it will add 1-1, it will give 1-0. So my carry will be 1 and my sum will be 0. So this is the working of full adder, which are 3 bits A, B and C in. You can take various other readings at different input states and take the output. Now we have different circuits of adder, subtractor, half adder, subtractor, full subtractor and multiplexers. These are the circuits of multiplexer, encoder and this is decoder. You can study it from a manual and perform the experiments and take the desired readings. The breadboard circuit trainer is also used for the counters, which we have 3-bit counters, 3-bit synchronous ripple up counters. The exact circuit is given in our manual how to connect it. These are the various ICs that we have to use in this 7476 for the 3-bit down counter. Connect it according to the circuit given in our manual and take the desired readings according to the table given below it. So we have different counters and we also have parallel in parallel output operations, PPO, like this. These are the various experiments that can be performed on this equipment. These are the various experiments that it perform on this equipment by using the different ICs that we have provided with you with this kit. So you can use this kit for various experiments, various number of experiments, which can be performed very successfully through this kit, and it is a very helpful kit for the learning of digital electronics. That's it in this equipment. For any further information, please do consult the lab manual. Thank you.